Welcome to an introductory lesson on the stars and bars method of counting. Let's begin by considering a question. You have 7 cookies to give to 4 children. How many ways can you do this? Take a moment to think about how you might solve this problem. You may assume it is acceptable to give a child no cookies. Also, the cookies are all identical, and the order in which you give out the cookies does not matter. Now think about how you could specify such an outcome. In terms of cookies, we need to say after how many cookies do we stop giving cookies to the first child and start giving cookies to the second child. And then after how many do we switch to the third child, and then after how many do we switch to the fourth. One way to represent an outcome would be to use stars and bars as shown below. This sequence of stars and bars indicates 3 cookies go to the first child, then we switch and give 1 cookie to the second child, and then we switch, give 1 cookie to the third child, and then we switch again and give the 2 remaining cookies to the fourth child. Notice that we need 7 stars and 3 bars, 1 star for each cookie, and 1 bar for each switch between children. So notice there's 1 fewer bars than there are children. We don't need to switch after the last child because we are done. A stars and bars chart, shown above, is just a string of symbols, some stars and some bars. If instead of stars and bars, we used zeros and ones, it would just be a bit string, and we know how to count those. But does any string of 7 bars and 3 stars correspond to a different way to distribute the cookies? And the answer is yes. Here's another sequence of stars and bars that represents a different way to give out the 7 cookies. This stars and bars chart represents a distribution in which the first child gets 0 cookies because we switched to the second child before any stars. The second child gets 3 cookies because of the 3 stars. Then we switch to the third child, but then we switch again to the fourth child, indicating the third child gets 0 cookies, and the fourth child gets the remaining 4 cookies. So no matter how these stars and bars are arranged, we can distribute cookies in that way. So now let's get back to our question. Again, you have 7 cookies to give to 4 children. How many ways can you do this? Each way to distribute cookies corresponds to a stars and bars chart with 7 stars and 3 bars. There are a total of 10 symbols, and we must choose 3 of them to be bars, and therefore, there are 10 choose 3 ways to distribute 7 cookies to 4 children, which is 120 ways. Notice how 10 choose 3 is formed by stars plus bars choose bars. But also remember, this is equivalent to stars plus bars choose stars. We will be able to apply this counting technique to several other interesting types of problems. If you are wondering why 10 choose 3, recall the number of 10 bit strings of weight 3 is 10 choose 3. This cookie problem is also equivalent to the number of solutions to the equation x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus x4 equals 7 for x1, x2, x3, x4 all greater than or equal to 0. And this should make sense. Notice x1, x2, x3, x4 would be the 4 children, and the sum is 7 because we have 7 cookies. So looking at the stars and bars chart above, in terms of the equation, this represents the solution where x1 equals 3, x2 equals 1, x3 equals 1, and x4 equals 2, which does give us a sum of 7 and satisfies the inequalities. Now let's extend our question. How many ways are there to distribute 7 cookies to 4 children so that each child gets at least 1 cookie? One approach is to first give each child a cookie. The remaining 3 cookies can be distributed to the 4 children without restrictions. There are 3 stars because there are 3 cookies remaining, and we still have 4 children, giving us 3 bars for a total of 6 symbols. Again, 3 of which must be bars. And therefore, there are 6 choose 3 ways to distribute 7 cookies to 4 children, giving at least 1 cookie to each child. And 6 choose 3 is equal to 20. So you might be asking, when do we use stars and bars? And here are some guidelines. We have 2 groups of objects, one of which is indistinguishable, one of which is indistinguishable, which are the stars, and one that is identifiable, which would be the bars. So in our case, we have 7 indistinguishable cookies, which is why we have 7 stars, and we have 4 identifiable children, which gives us 3 bars. We have a constraint that needs to be satisfied, such as an inequality or a lower bound, which we saw in the equation example, as well as the second example with the cookies, where each child gets at least 1 cookie. And then finally, we do not care about the order. I hope you found this helpful.